Sergeant speaking for the Local Primitives. Thanks for watching the video today. We're here talking about food procurement and different means of gaining food resources. We're going to go over a primitive method of doing it. Anybody who follows my Facebook saw that I put a picture up not too long ago about a primitive toolbox. I'm always out in the woods gathering primitive tools, looking for primitive means of sustaining life and keeping yourself alive out in the woods. One thing I got was this piece of birch here. I cut off of a downed birch tree. I'm going to make a rabbit stick out of this. Rabbit stick is a very primitive tool. It's got the name rabbit stick because it's used for hunting rabbits, small game, small animals, mostly ground-dwelling animals. The great thing, what you want to look for when you're getting a rabbit stick is obviously you want a good thickness of a stick, solid piece of wood. It's not going to break on you. Or it's not rotted. You can see here, I can almost touch my hands around the one end. A little bit skinnier on the other end, but that's still good. It's still workable. It's got a slight curve to it. I think almost like a boomerang. It's got a little bit of a curve to it, which is going to help in the throwing, the accuracy, and also in the way that this this weapon works on taking down small animals. Now you can see here, I shaved off some of the bark. It's not really any significance to the rabbit stick. I just shaved off some of this bark for kindling. You can shave it off if you want to keep this for a good period of time. You would want to shave all the bark off. That way the wood can dry and it won't rot on you. Reason you want a good length to it, you see, it's almost about arm's width or arm's length. That's a good distance to have it. Reason being, all this is your striking power. When you throw this, like I said, you're throwing this at animals on the ground, so if you're walking around hunting and you have your rabbit stick at the ready, you see something a little bit of a distance away from you, you got plenty of time to get this lined up and ready to fire. The idea behind this weapon is for it to be thrown in a sidearm motion. Your object is to aim at your target. You want to aim about a couple inches off the ground is where you want to be aiming, right in front of that target. That's going to ensure that you hit your target. You don't want to be throwing it directly at your target or anything wild like that. Just pick a spot about a foot in front of your target, a couple inches off the ground, and that's what you want to aim at. And then you're going to follow through where your aim point is, and that's going to hit your target. And you're going to throw this, like I said, at the sidearm motion. The reason you're going to do that, you're not going to throw it straight forward like this. When you throw it straight forward, this is the only amount of area that's going to hit something. Throwing it sideways gives you the spin. And the reason why you have this curve, the curve feature to this branch, which you want to look for a curve feature rather than a straight one, that's going to help it with its spin, almost like a wing of an aircraft in flight. It's going to help stabilize it, and it's going to help it give it more spin. And the way this weapon takes down your food resources is by blunt trauma. That's why you want a good thick stick, a good heavy piece of wood to be able to take down. It's going to hit hard, anything like a rabbit, a squirrel, a possum, anything like that. It's going to hit, it's going to knock it down. Might not kill it directly, but it's definitely going to be down and out for the count, or at least injured. That way you can move up to it and then take it out in the most quick and humane way you can to completely take that animal. So what we're going to do is we're going to give us a little test. Like I said, it's just like any other skill. Even like firing a firearm, you're never going to hit the target the first time. You're never going to be a marksman the first time. It takes some practice. So the reason I gathered this a while ago is so I could take it and practice with it, get used to it. That way, if a time comes where I do need to use one of these, I'll be able to do it more accurately. Just like I mentioned, with any survival technique, practice is what makes it perfect. Practice is what's going to help you do it successfully. You just can't read a book, watch a video, try to remember it, then go out there in the woods and you find yourself in a real survival experience when you got plenty of emotions, plenty of fear, plenty of stress and all that working towards you, and try to recall something that you just read or watched in a video. It's going to be pretty much impossible. And it's definitely going to hinder your survival experience rather than increase your likelihood of survival. So as you watch these videos like this one here, go out in the woods, find yourself a rabbit stick, fashion one, and do some practice. As you can see, I'm not going to be perfect with mine. Probably won't even hit the target. Hopefully I do. But I know if I practice it, it definitely will improve, and this will definitely be a technique I can use in the future. As you can see off in the distance there, I'm out here in this area, kind of flattening down a little bit with my truck. I got my bag sitting out there. It's going to be a good 10 meters away, but we're just going to suppose that that's a little rabbit out there, Peter Cottontail's out there, and we're hungry and we want Peter Cottontail. So I'm going to go ahead and practice with my rabbit stick a few times to see how it goes. As you can see, this is why they invented shotgun. Alright, as you can see, I just got a hit there on our target. So hopefully that were a rabbit or any kind of small little critter, that blow would have been enough to knock it out. I definitely need to practice my technique, just like I mentioned you should. As you saw, I missed a few times, and but after a while, you kind of get the feel. It's just like throwing knives, throwing hatchets, throwing a baseball, throwing a football, anything like that. It's all about mechanics and getting the feel for where you got to let go. Once you hit it a few times, you start to get that feeling of where you got to throw it, just like throwing a baseball to a catcher if you're a pitcher. You just can't expect to stand on the mound and throw a strike the first time. It takes a while to build that muscle memory, and that's why, just like this technique, fire starting, hundreds of other things that we do out in the bush, most of it all takes practice. And a lot of these people that you see out there that do make videos like I do instruct classes, one, they're always still learning and always still gathering new information, plus they're always practicing their craft. So you got time, go out in the woods, go to your personal space, get you a rabbit stick, get out there and practice. Then once you feel confident, if you want to, you can try it out for real. Hope I get the opportunity sometime when I'm out hunting. I might carry my rabbit stick with me, just in case. So, but it is a very primitive, a very effective means of gaining food. And so check it out, try it out, get you a stick and practice. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you learned something. And I hope you go out and practice this skill. I'm Sergeant Speakman, Earthwalker Primitives. Thank you.